Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. I'm the RPG check. Hole in the ceiling, huh? Look at that too. I got a bunch of things to look at. Playing Wilbur, of course. We really need to defeat Munkus. Appears he's been impersonating me and, well, impersonating Wilbur and impersonating the Archmage Alice. No, not the Archmage Alistair, the Headmaster Block as well. Well, Blockhead. Let's look at the hole in the ceiling.
The moon is shining through the hole. That could be my way out of here.
Yeah, so the Archmage was turned into a frog, and we don't know where he is at this point. And the Councilwoman Van Buren, her daughter, is able to do things with the wand that Wilbur can't, which has him rather upset, understandably. Thinking at this point that the magic doesn't come from him at all, but the wand.
If the situation in Seastone really is as dismal as Remy says it is, I'll have to be very careful once I leave the hole. That said, first, I gotta get up there.
Right.
Looks like, a V-belt. I wonder how it got up there.
What's a V-belt?
Clearly out of my reach.
Wear your paper hat. Just because.
There's a few artificial columns and arches here, as well as natural caves. I wouldn't be surprised if there was some mining done here once.
I'm not going to climb on that yet. Let's look at this.
The bit of sewer pipe is so heavy that it's sunk halfway into the ground over the years. Not surprising, really. The ground here isn't stone. It's firmly trodden waste. I wonder where the pipe comes from. Seastone is known, or shall we say, infamous, for not having any sewers to speak of. Maybe someone wanted to change that, and this is both the beginning and the end of their efforts.
I thought there were loads of sewers. That's where the rats lived.
A bit of sewer pipe is so heavy. Not so.
Look at that cloth thing.
What's this? Some kind of little bag. I'll take it with me.
Automatically.
Bag with a drawstring. Empty.
Rubbish.
This must be garbage from the upper town. The tableware might not be the latest word in fashion, but it's perfectly fine, apart from the leftovers.
Take it all.
No, I think I'll just leave it there. The plates are covered in greasy leftover sauce, and I'm not a fan of washing up.
I told you to take them.
Especially when I didn't even dirty them myself.
Ah, sheesh. Take them.
No, I think I'll just leave it there. The plates are...
Look at this rubbish. Really different from the rubbish over there.
A fur collar that looks almost new. Why would you throw something like that away? One could have given it to the poor, or even left it on the chinchillas. That's all I wanted. Strip of pretty long head fur.
What's this? Cables up here.
Couple of power lines. They lead through the ceiling somewhere up there. One strand goes into the rats' camp, the other leads down towards the junkyard. I always thought Gnomehole was the only place with electricity. But beyond the Whitebridge Mountains, it's been used here and there for years. I always thought Gnomehole...
So what happens if I go in this?
Maybe I can get a better view from up there. Yep, definitely better. Not decisively, though. completely out of my reach.
You weren't supposed to get off there. Oh, he got off. Wait. Hold on. I want to see if maybe from here. Ugh. Never mind. So what's the sense of... Let's climb up there then. I don't know what the sense of standing on that is. What we got here? A wooden figure.
Hey! That's a knight that says knee! A huge mountain of rubbish. Tons of it. And I just happened to find a carved figurine of my very favorite hero. It's a sign. I've read all your stories. He was brave and proud, and he never gave up.
Seriously?
Because of you, I wanted to experience adventure and left the White Bridge Mountains. And you were only a story.
Ugh. Can't believe you threw it away. I'll take the cloak then.
A little cape that someone made for the wooden knight knee figure. A bell. I guess it's there to get people's attention. Which is usually what bells are for.
Ring my bell.
Should I ring it or not? Do I really want the attention of someone up there? But the hole seems to be the only way if I ever want to get out of here. Yes? Are you finally finished? Bill? That you? Withervane? A black cat must have crossed my path. Yes? It's me. Could you maybe loan me a rope?
For a price.
No way. You're a wanted criminal. There are posters of you up all over.
Oops. I'm not a criminal.
No matter what they say, I didn't kill the Archmage.
It's not even death.
Anyone with any brains knows that. You couldn't have harmed a hair on the Archmage's head, even if you wanted to. But as long as that's the official version of the story, I'd rather not think about it out loud.
There are posters of me in the town?
There are posters of me hanging everywhere.
Here, not a bad likeness if you ask me.
Wanted for the murder of Archmage Alistair, the scurvy, dangerous, armed and stinky fiend Wilbur Weathervane.
Stinky?
I don't stink. Or if I do, it's only because I spend a few days in bed.
I told them if they wanted to catch you, they'd have to put a serious bounty on your head.
Would you betray me?
If the price is right, sure. But until then, I'm keeping my head down, like everyone else who's got any sense. Now, you gotta be smart these days, or you'll end up running around in a pink tutu, or worse.
What? A pink tutu? How are things in the town?
How's it look up there? How are things in town?
Dreadful. Not a customer in sight. It's almost as bad as during the war. I should have known. Politicians are bad for business. Every last one of them.
Please get me out of here. I won't cause any trouble.
Come on, get me out of here, Bill. I won't cause any trouble.
That'd be a first.
Please, I want to leave town.
Don't blame you, but it's too risky. If Van Buren catches me, she'll probably turn me into a pink, doe-eyed petting lamb.
Come on, for old time's sake.
I'm not putting my neck on the line for you. Ask your friends, those darn rats.
Well, that's that.
Bill? Bill, are you there?
Nope.
He'll never help me unless there's a juicy profit in it for him.
I know that.
Better not overdo it. I will only use the bell when I need to talk to Bill. The hole up there is even higher than I thought. I'm going to need more than a folding ladder if I want to reach it. The hole up there, I'm going
to... Let's go back down. Alright, so... We can go into a lit area, we can go into a dark cave. Let's go into the lit area. Oh, let's look at this poster.
This person is considered armed and dangerous. Like I even own a land shark gun. As if.
A land shark gun.
Bag with a drawstring. Empty.
See. Ooh.
Wow! A workshop worthy of a gnome. I wonder whose it is.
Maybe it is a gnome's. Let's look at the junk over here first.
Everything down here is old and used. Some of it's pretty strange too. But every single thing now has a second life and a new task. Everything down here is old, but every...
Cuckoo clock.
Oh, this is a clock cuckoo's nest. They are so rare.
A clock cuckoo's nest?
They build their nests in human houses and disguise them as clocks. When the homeowners aren't looking, they fly around and steal cookies and other treats.
That's funny.
Although it looks more like a replica of a clock cuckoo's nest. There are people who actually hang these things in their living rooms. The clock isn't ticking. Presumably, it can be wound through the little hexagonal hole in the dial if you have the right key. The clock isn't...
Let's look at this machine.
As a gnome, I can recognize what that is immediately. A garbage sucker, which sucks garbage in the front and blows it out the back. Some might wonder why, but good inventors never ask such questions.
Wooden box.
A small box with a switch on it. I will resist.
Those are one of those boxes that turn themselves off, isn't it? I'll die if that's what it is.
That
I knew
be
it.
The best machine ever built.
I knew it.
Just one more time.
Now, one more time. What's even better is the ones with the... that they do random things. They, the thing spins around and all this. Plays different songs.
Oh. This thing has way too many cogwheels, levers, and gauges for me. All of the other members of my family would definitely know what to do with this. But all I ever wanted to do was... magic. Some sort of machine. And since I'm not only a flop at magic, but also know absolutely nothing about technology, I have no idea what it's for.
Electric cables?
Two power cables have been connected here. Not very professionally, I'd say. I'd better leave it alone.
For sure. Never say such a thing.
Two power, not very... Works! Works!
Works! I don't know what to do with this stuff. If anything. Oh, it's a stone that...
This is the strangest rock I've ever seen.
Yeah.
It glitters and it glows a little.
Yeah, I wasn't sure what the hell this thing was.
That thing looks magical to me. I don't want anything to do with it.
You like magical.
That thing looks...
Boards.
Why build something out of wood when you can build it out of iron? That was one of my granddad's favourite sayings. That philosophy brought me iron toys, iron shoes for the garden, and lucky, my iron horse. Someone took the trouble to cut the boards, and I don't need them at the moment.
Alright, what else? We've got these cables.
Electrical cable. This workshop is amazingly well equipped, considering it was built from scrap. No idea why they're there. Best leave them alone. I had a few shocking experiences with electricity back home.
Shocking experiences, huh? Oh, there's a steam engine here.
Boiler, combustion chamber, flywheel, a steam engine, clearly. The steam engine is probably supposed to power the strange machine next to it. Doesn't look like it ever did, though. The engineer must have run into a snag. The steam engine doesn't look like it ever... Some sort of machine...
Alright. Huh. Well, I don't know what to do with any of this stuff. Oops, sorry about that, guys. We're stuttering here.
Everything down here is old and used. Some of it's pretty strange, too. But every...
Well, let's go into the dark cave. Hi.
Ah, Wilbur. There you are. Have you changed your mind?
Yes.
No. I just want to get out of here.
Aw.
Highly regrettable.
You want to go down that rope? What do you hope to find down there?
What do you want down there in that dark hole?
I found your one down there years ago. My grandfather, a true rat adventurer of lore, climbed into that hole just to find out what was down there. When he didn't return, everyone thought he was dead, apart from me.
You followed him?
Despite all the warnings, but I didn't find him. Instead, I found a wand. Just as I began examining it, a terrifying ghost set upon me and I fled. I don't know why I took the wand with me. Perhaps it wanted to be taken. When a little gnome came down to our town some years later with big ideas of becoming a mage...
Oh, look at that bit. Yeah, I wonder.
I found my wand and... Oh.
How do you think that the magic wand got there?
How did the magic wand get there? And whose was it?
I don't know. There are old ruins down there, and lots of terrible tales. If I can find out whose wand it is, then perhaps I can find a way to break its power.
Hmm. The wand has been behaving a bit oddly for a while. I just didn't pay much attention to it.
The wand. It began behaving weirdly a few days earlier. I thought I was getting better at magic. I should have paid more attention.
And Alistair should have examined it more closely. And I shouldn't have asked you to build a golem. No one is to blame for what happened, or we're all to blame, whichever way you choose to see it. What is important is that we get up and go again.
No, it's crucial that we think first. The last time I just carried on, and we know how that ended up.
Do you believe that the ghost is still down there?
This ghost that followed you back then, do you think it's still down there?
I haven't dared return to the darkness for years, because I'm convinced of it.
Then maybe you shouldn't go back down there.
Perhaps you're right, but someone's got to go and find out what's going on with that wand, right? Courage and conviction, Wilbur. Courage and conviction.
I didn't get a chance to thank you. I wanted to choose the other options.
The hole is eerie. Whenever you get close, it feels like icy fingers are reaching for you.
Well, I guess then the icy fingers have Remy.
Remy will be fine. He's tough, he's smart, brave. Everything a hero should be. And nothing ever happens to heroes.
Who the hell told you that?
Hopefully. The hole is... Whenever you... Maybe it's a symbol warning visitors about the evil in the hole. Or maybe it keeps the evil trapped down there. There are ancient symbols that can do just that. Back in the Whitebridge Mountains, I had to listen to long lectures by the cellar master about different types of stone and minerals. Can't really claim that I listened all that attentively, but that looks like a coal vein to me. Back in the Whitebridge Mountains,
Let me smudge some coal on here.
How does something like that end up in the trash? If I had a bongo drum, I'd play it all day long and night. And then others would throw it in the trash. Ah, got it. Yeah. I don't feel like playing. I want to get out of here. I want to go home.
Well, just take it then.
I don't feel like playing.
All right then.
Back in the Whitebridge, can't really claim that I...
Oh, what's up there?
Someone had to install the pipes down here. How did they get into the underground? And even more importantly, how did they get back out? The design doesn't look too stable. On the other hand, it doesn't look like it was built any time recently either, which in turn speaks for its durability. The design doesn't look too stable. A massive pipe, perhaps iron or lead. Presumably it transports something from the town into one of the caves down here. And probably, I really, really don't want to know what it is. A massive pipe, and
Hamster wheel?
There isn't much you won't find down here. Hamster wheels, for example.
Oh, we got a hamster wheel.
Doesn't look like the wheel got used much. Somewhere there's a lazy fat hamster.
Attach the fur to the wheel?
The fur would fall out right away. I need some way to attach it.
Why do we want to attach fur to a hamster wheel?
A massive pipe. Perhaps iron or lead. Presumably it transports something from the town into one of the caves down here. And probably...
Alright. Ooh. What's that?
Ah! What the heck?
Uh-oh.
Hey! What's the big idea?
There's a robot. Rallus Crud... What?
Did you build this trap? I'd love to, but I'm stuck.
How do you understand that?
Hey! Stop that! Stop that! Are you nuts?
Short stick? He's poking us with a stick.
A small stick. About one sea stone cubit in length.
Hello?
Hey, little fella. I could use some help here. Hello? I think it's trying to hide from me. I probably scared it. It doesn't respond to me. Maybe it just wants to sit the whole thing out. It doesn't respond to me. An old rope, still in pretty good shape.
Take.
I can't quite reach.
There you go.
Got it!
Oops.
An old rope. Still in pretty good shape. I'll tie the stick to the rope. Done. I tied the little stick to the end of the rope. I don't know if that'll be any use, but I did it. The fur would fall out right away. I need some way to attach it.
Alright, what else can we look at?
A massive pipe, and...
We just got something else? It fell apart!
I'll tie the stick to the rope. Done.
Why'd it fall apart? Here, let's just tie this.
Still too light.
It fell apart again.
The hamster wheel has the right weight, but it's too unwieldy to throw with the rope. I'll tie the stick to the rope. Done. I wonder if I... No. Even if I could catch it with a lasso, it doesn't look strong enough to pull me out of here.
Lasso? A lasso.
I wonder if... Even if... I don't know how deep the hole is. My feet can't touch the ground anyway. I'm a gnome. I'm not sliding in any deeper, but I can't get out either. I'm stuck, like a cork in a bottle. I don't know how deep. I'm not...
Well... Offer the robot the empty bag.
If you let me get out of here, I'll give you a stylish and practical empty bag. Nothing.
You want some fur type stuff?
I have a very expensive, very fluffy fur. If you get me out of here, it's yours. Nothing.
How about a cloak? You could be a superhero. Oh, we don't have that option. Use the robot with the poster?
Maybe it's a kind of bounty hunter and he's captured me because of the poster. Not likely. Bill said they haven't put the bounty on me yet. I wonder if I... No. Even if I could catch it with... Still too light.
I don't know what to do.
The stick isn't a good enough weight for the rope. I can't get it high enough.
Well, can we find some kind of weight?
I wonder if, even if I... The hamster wheel has the right weight, but it's too unwieldy to throw with the rope. The hamster wheel...
Well, I don't know what to do.
I'd love to. I'd love to. I'll tie the stick to the rope. Done.
I don't know why I keep trying this.
Still too light. Hey, you! Hi there! I just want...
Okay, we've got a stone now.
An approximately fist-sized stone. That would really hurt if it hit me in the face. An approximately fist... Hope it stays on.
Me too. Let me just try this.
I could throw the stone at its head really hard, but then that would either knock the robot out or make it run off. Not much help either way, really.
Nope. This is the answer.
Yep. There we go. Great. And now, the old heave-ho. That got it. Hey, wait.
When you were out of the hole much longer and you were still going blah. Now take the rope.
The rope helped me once. Maybe it can again. The rope helped me once.
Mm-hmm.
How does something like that end up in the trap? And...
Nah. All right. Where'd the robot go? Oh, I didn't know I could look back in here.
The cook hasn't left my side for a moment. Remy probably told her to watch me. I think she's a little cuckoo. She mumbles to herself all the time.
What are you talking about? She hasn't been with us. She hasn't left your side.
Hello.
Good God, oh God. My, how you've grown.
I'm Wilbur.
Stew.
You're the cook, and your name is Stew. Isn't that kind of metaphysical? In a cosmos composed of names, billions upon billions of names, you, a cook, are named Stew. Destiny? Fate, blind chance, mere coincidence, a fine kettle of fish indeed.
They called her that because she cooks.
Cause, effect, that's all. Ethel's my name. Want some stew?
There you go. Name isn't even Stew. So you look after all the rats down here?
So you're the cook here in the rats camp?
Yes. I am good at fixing things. Was a lab rat for years.
You worked in a lab?
For a mad alchemist, until it got too dangerous. Wanted me to trial a face cream that would make you look 10 years younger. I was only 2 at the time.
Oh, right. I get it.
From then on, I tried to be really stupid, attempted to fail at every experiment. The question is, if one tries to fail and is successful doing that, has one really failed?
That's a brain twister. Does your wooden leg come from the time you spent with the alchemist?
Can I ask what happened to your leg? An alchemistical accident?
No, I gnawed it off myself.
Oh my God.
What?
Down there in the cave. You'd have done the same. Ooh.
Really?
Somehow, I just really doubt that.
There are monsters there, I'm telling you. And they've got it in for us. If you have to choose between your leg and your life, then you nibble.
Can you brew magic potions?
If you know a lot about alchemy, then you can brew potions, right? Like shrinking potions, for example.
Oh, don't hold much store by magic potions. People start craving them. Start with weak potions from itsy bitsy little vials, then at some point they aren't enough anymore. Suddenly it's got to be small potions, then medium, then large, then epic.
A single vial that would shrink me back to the size of a rat would be enough for me.
Oh, no, no. Much too dangerous.
So what's on your menu today?
What are you cooking?
Stew. It's always stew.
Mmm. Tasty. What kind?
It's always the same. Has been for years, but new things are added every day. Whatever happens to appear. Do you want a bowl full?
Probably not. What's in this stew?
What exactly is in the stew?
Vitamins, carbohydrate, bit of fat, roughage, fluoride. Want some?
That's not what I meant.
Bodies are alchemistic machines. They aren't interested where their energy and lubricants come from.
Well, I am.
But my stomach might.
Oh, don't be daft. All the rubbish is perfectly fresh, and I know what I'm doing. So, want a bowl or not?
Perhaps later.
No. I don't think so.
Oh, come on. You going to insult an old lady?
But I'm not hungry.
Don't be daft. You need to grow big and strong.
But...
Well, there is no option.
That... this tastes fantastic.
Cooking is like alchemy. Just fewer explosions.
I guess it's made of, like, bull testicles or something.
The bowls are made for rats. That means they can't hold much more than a spoonful of soupy stew.
Okay. Stay tuned next time and we're gonna look around in here and talk to Ethel some more, perhaps. Thanks for watching. See you next... That's cute. See you next time in a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.